friendly, dude. Come on. You want to go up the hill with me? A little further up? What do you think? Ooh, look at the camera. Say cheese. You got to stay out of the... I know the sun feels good, but you got to stay out of the road. Muddy. My buddy rode this morning and he said Diablo was booby trapped by some hikers. Bunch of big rocks and places that they shouldn't be. Kind of lame. You never seen a hiker fix a trail after the rain, have you? Happy Monday. We're out at Troy Lee Trail Skyline. Got Andre. Biggie's over there adding to the moisture on the trail. Riding the SML Test Intense Taser Alloy C. Pretty awesome bike, to be honest. Olin suspension is really, really plush. I'm really impressed with these tires, Pirelli's. I guess this set of Pirelli tires was developed especially for the Taser C. And Olin suspension, a lot better than I expected. Everything about this bike is kind of surprising. So through the month of March, you can use the code SML10 at Intense to get a better price. I think this bike's only 6,500 bucks or something, so really good deal compared to the carbon bikes that aren't much better. So Biggie's joining the dark side today. E-bike, electric E.
The electric side.
E and electric start with, you know, Big E.
Yeah.
Eric, E.
Good thing it's just a loner.
Huh? He's going to call Mike. I want it.
Yeah, I might. Actually.
Makes
coming up Skyline was too easy.
Yeah, it was easy, huh? Thank you. Supercross ball pair. What's that? Your brake? Your brake?
It's not just talent, it's like metal grinding.
They sound hot.
Yeah. I wonder why.
We're at Kuya Creek today. Kind of empty. I don't know, I guess it's an average crowd. But I got here at 9.
Scrubby's already riding. Brought the trusty 450. I still haven't brought myself to put the rest of my graphic kit on. Mostly because I like the way it looks stock. But, still got this crazy thing on. Can't talk about it though. Anyway, I rode at Glen Helen yesterday. It was super muddy. And I forgot that I fell at the end of the day. I guess I could better clean this up before I ride. It's gonna be nasty. But yeah, super excited to ride. I'm bummed that Chase isn't here with me, but he's laid out for 4 months with a lacerated liver. That didn't sound like Scrubby because I didn't hear all the clutching. Oh, there he is. He's down there. We'll see if we can get the clutch action on audio. See, he's down there cruising at like 30% and then he goes fast over the jump for everyone watches. That's why he stays out there for so long. Here he comes. Abusing that silencer packing. Anyway, yeah, let's check out the steed. I have to say, these W edge wheels, these are the ones that they call entry level or whatnot. I've had these on for, I'd say almost a year, because I had them on my last bike. And they're awesome, as straight as an arrow. Even the front. And I'm like the king of case. And yeah. So we've got the X-Trig Rocks clamps, which I like. I usually don't like aftermarket triple clamps. So they change the feel of the bike, but these are actually more comfortable. These things. I actually have come to love them. I was a little worried about liking them too much and then feeling odd on other bikes when I don't have them, but it doesn't seem to be the case. Looks like I need to get a new pipe sticker. Keep falling on that thing. Stop falling, Don. sad news. SDG, Jeff Chrisman, my buddy who's done our seats at Swapmoto Live and Transworld for years and years. I think he's shut down the company and he's found another job. But I love this ribbed out seat. Yeah, there's that thing I can't talk about. FCP engine mounts give the bike a little softer feel and acceleration chop. Front and rear. And these Pro Taper ACF bars. I've had these things for over a year and I crashed a lot and they're not bent. So, very proud of these things and impressed. I think I had them. I had the first set when they were still pre-production before they were available. There we go. I heard him coming. I knew it was him. So, you rode the whole time I've been here.
I rode an hour already.
So, what you do is you cruise when you're all over there when no one can see you. Save your energy. No. And then when you're in front of everybody, you quadruple clutch it and go all fast.
I'm going fast all the way around, but I'm trying to lift my shoulders.
I watched you down there. You're like sitting around, like going like this.
Yeah, because I'm tired. I've been out there on the track since 8:20. I was scared I was going to run out of gas.
Did you have a honey bun tucked in your sleeve? You're eating over in the corner.
Hey, but I'll tell you this. If you don't go out there, you're going to be mad because it's getting...
The track's going away?
Yeah.
Already?
I did it all.
It looks perfect.
No, it's good. They need to water a little bit, but it's so good right now.
Oh. It's a little windy, huh?
Yep.
Windy by the flag jump.
Yeah, it's real windy over there. I went for that jump once and like, okay, I'm good.
Nice. Thanks for not wearing the same gear as me today.
You know what's funny? I had that one.
You had this?
But you know, I like the way A-Ray did it. You see how
he did it on accident, dude, because his jersey got muddy.
It looked good.
No, it did. It didn't match. It did match. Oh, look at him. Finally checking his fork pressure.
Hey, what is going on here? Hey, why are things lighting up?
You've never used this before, have you?
No.
How long have you had this bike? 2 months? 3 months?
What is this? To let it out?
Okay, wait. First of all, Chase got you this when?
Yeah.
Like a month ago?
Yeah.
So this, you pull this out and then the battery touches. Okay? Now you turn it on. So you got 10.4 bar in there.
Oh, that's good.
How many bar are you supposed to have?
Chase said 10.5.
Okay, then pump it to 10.5.
All right.
Oh my God, dude. Oh my God.
I almost would have never pulled that out.
You just leave all the plastic on. That's like your couches at home, huh?
Yep.
You still got the plastic covers on?
Oh my God.
Okay, this is our buddy Todd Ford from Custom Outfits. Is this your personal van or is this like a...
This is my real deal.
Are you giving this one away? You give everything else away.
My wife will kill me for this one.
Ooh, this is beautiful. This is the biggest one you get. Four-wheel drive. Dually?
Dually extended.
Dually extended.
From our friends over there at Walter's Mercedes-Benz in Riverside.
Yeah. Just don't take your bike, your truck there for an oil change. $600. Wow. So this is what your van looks like when you own the company that makes them. Super cool. And then this is Ken Robson's bike. This is the one that Ken Robson didn't race because he's on a Suzuki. Pat Foster said it's the best 450 he's ever ridden. We're going to creep inside this van. Oh, I know we're walking though. What?
Just go through the back door.
Yeah, I was going to walk through that puddle.
But why?
The boot dryers.
Well, why? When you can just walk straight in.
Well, I got dirty motocross feet, dude. Dude, this thing is nice.
All the nice and dust. My guy at work, he just does amazing.
Leather padding.
Oh, new. We're new for the van in van life world.
Swiveling captain's chairs.
Better.
What is this? Oh, this turns into a bed?
Yep.
Oops. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
And this folds out.
This is a bed. This is a bed, and then that bed that comes out and hangs. So you gotta sleep four people in here, no problem.
Wow. Have you slept on this?
No.
I think I would roll off.
But if this is out, it covers.
Then you fall on the person sleeping there.
Yes.
Dude, okay, so is this like everything you could do? Like the
literally
TT
everything. Yeah. Yeah, 32 inch Samsung. You can hook it to your phone or Starlink. Air conditioner will still run on the batteries, even though it's a 110 setup.
And there's a big old solar panel on the roof,
Two solar panels on the roof. This one has a deck on the roof now. I got, it's like 68 inches by 4 feet.
Deck you could sit on?
Yeah. So you can go up on the side and then microwave.
I think this is the most beautiful van I've seen you build.
I upgraded the stereo system, so I put an amp and
a subwoofer. For that gangster rap you listen to?
When you're cranking some Yanni, when you're driving down the freeway heading to Southern California,
up in Sacktown?
Yeah.
Damn, it smells good in here. Is it the fabric or you have a little tree?
It's the sex wax.
Okay. Nice. So what is this?
This is the memory maker.
What is this?
We call this one the memory maker.
What is this build at retail?
The way it sits with all the custom stuff, it's right around 55.
That's it?
Yeah, and I got it, and we did in a
second. 55 year cost. Or 55 retail.
Retail.
Come on, dude.
And
really?
Then, and you get a, and then I also put a second alternator on this also. Mm-hmm. So my alternator basically powers everything from the driver's seat back.
And it's separate from the the engine
bay. And it just gives me more constant power. So if we want to run the air conditioner while we're driving, we can. And all the other stuff like that. So nice. Got a refrigerator.
Refrigerator down
no
there.
No beer in it yet. But
yeah, microwave. Where's the washing machine? The washing machine. The guy out there has a washing machine for you.
He does.
It's in the back of his truck.
Oh, we even have dividers too in there, so you can like drop these curtains down in case you're, you know.
It's sexy time.
Definitely sexy time.
So let's check this out. It's Thursday and it rained like most of the night. It's nice and clear now, but Glen Helen's gonna be a mud bog, so instead of doing that, say bye to the wife. We're gonna do a bunch of errands today. Super inefficient,
I wish I could have planned it out better, but I live in Corona. I'm driving south to the office to drop off
the Stark,
because Justin from Stark's coming over to the office at noon. I gotta pick up the kegs 450 and then haul ass to Orange County, passing my house to Orange County, go to Enzo, pick up Chase's forks for the YZ250F, drop off the KX450, and haul ass back. On the way back, past Troy Lee Designs to pick up some mountain bike test gear, and then go by Race Tech to pick up our Gas MC65, and then go back to the office by noon, because Justin from Stark is coming to take a look at the bike. And then we're gonna put the 65 together. The guys from T-Rex hooked us up with a bunch of cool parts for that bike that we're building. So it's a throttle, and then this is a triple clamp. I'm telling, I've been told every 65 national championship at Loretta Lynn's last year had a T-Rex throttle or triple clamp. And then what else? He gave us a sprocket, t-shirt, some different aluminum parts, and then a throttle cable, which is like Teflon coated on the inside. It's supposed to be super duper smooth. T-Rex low friction. This whole mini bike scene is all foreign to me because I have two girls, and trying to learn about it a little bit. Like when the Wampler boys told me to get a T-Rex throttle for the gas, I was all, T-Rex? What is that? Well, look at this thing. It's a billet. So yeah, look at the customization and the personal service. Dan from T-Rex, he's a badass. So why am I taking the Cowie to look at that bike over there. Beautiful, right? But why am I taking the Kawasaki to Enzo? I'll show you. I'm very lucky that my friend Takakatsuya has connections in Japan. Are you ready for this? So obviously the Cowie that we have is a 50th anniversary edition. So he can hand carry these to me from Japan. Are you ready? I don't think you're ready for this. Boom! Blue fork tubes for the KX450. It's first 125 I ever owned was a 91 KX125, which the 50th anniversary bike is based on, and it had blue forks. So when I was looking at the bike, I was like, damn, only if they made the forks blue. And Taka, Japanese guy who grew up in Australia, says, hey mate, I can get you blue ones. So voila. Gonna get the suspension tuned up a little bit and get the fork tubes put on. Hey, bad dog, come on. Let's go. That's stop one, Enzo Racing. Come in the back door. There's Yoshi. Cody. You good? What's up? What are you doing?
Labeling springs.
Labeling? Oh. Now changing the spring rate with a Dremel?
No.
This is my brother's workshop. Super channel. Says Yoshi Fun. Ross isn't here yet. He's probably at ceramics. Get suspension dropped off. There we go. Oh, here we go. Chase Curtis. Finished March 1st. Too bad Chase won't be riding this anytime soon. But still, gonna put the bike together. This is all to be done. Joshua Stark. So we got Chase's forks. The guys don't know I'm dropping this off, so I'm trying to butter them up with t-shirts.
Yoshi.
Oh,
wow. すごい.
Yes, I know. This is aura.
Okay. I think that's going to look pretty good.
So you have helper here at Enzo now. New helper.
Already Sam joined to us a couple of months ago. A
couple months ago?
Yeah.
After Tyler? Tyler before, Sayonara? Before. Oh, before?
Before, yeah. He already come here.
So Sam, you're retired, but you're working.
I'm not really working here. Huh?
You're just helping.
Yeah, oh, helping, yeah.
He's good helper for
good
us.
Good helper for you, yeah.
Yeah. I think so.
So, Sam Mishima was, were you Team Honda race team manager or supervisor?
I wasn't really a team manager. I was just
racing.
Like Brandon is right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So. Do you miss it?
A little bit, but not entirely.
You don't miss the travel, right?
Traveling was okay. It's a lot of other stuff that I didn't really care for, but,
oh, yeah. Okay.
But I miss racing for sure. Yeah.
So I see you every Wednesday at the Rob Healy GoFundMe ride day.
Yeah.
Where he overcharges us to ride. But so you still like riding quite a bit.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Do you only ride LACR on Wednesdays? You ride?
No,
on
I go to Cahia. I go to Grand Helen every once in a while. You know, I mainly ride vet track, but you know. Uh-huh. So.
Nice. Yeah. What did you think of the year they had last year at Honda?
Amazing.
Yeah?
Amazing. Unbelievable.
How much bonuses do you think they had to pay out?
A lot. Yeah. I don't know if they had the insurance.
Yeah, right?
But, I don't know.
So the personnel also get bonuses, right?
I believe so. Like, yeah, not like as much as I
just not did, as
but
riders,
Maybe
you should ask for a bonus because you laid the groundwork.
Yes, that's a good idea.
Yeah?
Huh? I might do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, good seeing you, Sam.
Right.
Yoshi.
Yes, sir.
Kawi, maybe tomorrow?
Tonight.
Tonight, yeah, maybe tonight. I'll go eat and I'll come back, okay? Dodge over.
Holy.
All right, stop one done. Actually, I already went to the shop and picked up the Cowie to bring here. Almost ran out of gas on the way here. Almost ran out of diesel, rather. And so now, going to Troy Lee, pick up a set of gear from Tim Daniels, and then going to Race Tech to pick up the Gas 65. And the dog has my van covered in hair. But it's a good day. It's not raining, at least. And so Enzo, obviously, is my brother's shop. Not the most Sano spick and span place, but they do legendary work there. I would say, how many years ago? Maybe almost 10 years ago now, he was short on staff. So I went in there and helped 3 days a week for like a month and a half or so. And it was the hardest time of my life. I was just the breakdown bitch, but dude, that shit is hard. I had blisters on the bottom of my pinky toes from like bracing myself on the ground while I was leveraging the suspension and stuff. But anyhow, yeah, on to Troy Lee. Okay, now we're at Troy Lee Designs. Tim Daniels here coming through with a set of mountain bike gear for our gas test. I think you're like the only person I know here now other than Carly and Max and sometimes Troy.
10 years in, man.
10 years in.
Yeah.
Dude, what is the official position now?
Marketing manager.
Marketing manager.
Yep. So,
wow.
Bike and moto side, a little bit of both.
Yeah.
So
of all the people that have been here and gone, who do you miss the most?
Oh, man. What a question.
I know I could answer who you missed the least.
But, I'll give a shout out to my guy Stickman.
Stickman's not here anymore?
No.
Did he retire?
No, he's at SRAM now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so.
I gotta hit him up. I need a seat post.
There you go.
So is Stickman the connection with SRAM? Because I know you guys always have a SRAM version and stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he's kind of the bridge between that gap there. Okay. We still got our partnership. This year, we're actually launching some new gear on the 20th, actually, of March.
Nice.
And so we'll have a SRAM collection in there also.
Oh, that's cool.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm all about SRAM. There's someone at Shimano I don't care for, so.
There you go.
All my bikes I changed to SRAM.
Nice.
So what's new at TLD?
Busy month, really.
Yeah.
We got a lot of product launching this month on both sides of the brand, bike and moto.
Uh-huh.
On the 1st of March, we just launched our new bike helmet collection.
Mm-hmm.
The 20th, we are launching the bike gear collection. The 13th is going to be our moto helmet collection.
Oh, wow.
And then the 27th is going to be our moto gear collection. So, yeah, a lot of product launches this month. And then we got some collaboration products also launching with some partner brands this mm-hmm. month as well. So, in total, there's seven different launches in March for
wow.
us. Yeah.
Are you guys selling the Ghostbusters gear?
We are not. No, we are not. Unfortunately, I know there's been some popular demand, but
yeah.
The race team might be making another special appearance in that for another uh-huh. round down the road.
I thought that the Waste Management Open.
Oh yeah,
cool.
Yeah, Phoenix. That was a nice collaboration with Puma, who's a team sponsor on the moto side, and then Palm Tree Crew, which is also like an offshoot brand of theirs. So
yeah,
good nice. Stuff though.
How much riding are you doing yourself these days?
Not much at all. No.
Are you too busy career guy?
Or? I'm more of a golfer. Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
so Ricky Fowler, right up my alley there.
Yeah, right.
So
nice.
Yep.
All right. So can you show me what we have here?
Yeah.
The
yeah.
helmet, at least, right? Is this a new helmet?
Helmet just came out. This is actually a D4 polyacrylate, so a new take on the D4 for us.
Mm-hmm.
D3's gone away. D4 poly's taken its place. Same safety, same features, all that good stuff, but at a nicer price point.
Yeah.
So we're doing some more solids on this. On the carbons and composites, you're going to see like some more wild graphics,
mm-hmm.
Keeping it a little bit more tame, but still that Troy Designs paint style is kind of coming through.
Yep.
With the matte and the gloss kind of combination finish there and some nicer details.
Yeah, I see the MIPS inside.
Yep,
exactly. Dude, it's funny, MIPS in a mountain bike helmet, I think it's honest because mountain bike crashes are largely silent without the motor.
Right.
But I've hit my head crashing a mountain bike and you can feel the MIPS move.
Really?
Like,
but not
real.
On moto, you don't notice it.
Moto, I'm usually just like, ah!
Yeah, yeah, shit, for sure. Right, so.
But yeah,
MIPS is a big partner with us. They've been in our helmets for quite a few years now, so.
Yeah.
Both on both sides. And then kind of dive into this a little bit too, just standard air glove, our best-selling
glove
there.
Helmet.
Yeah, exactly. Nice. Got you color coordinated. This is one of our more tame jerseys coming out, but this is just the standard Skyline, one of our best sellers. Mm-hmm. Casual fit, nice. Kind of tech in there, moisture wicking.
Yeah, named after the trail up the
local
hill.
Local trail, yeah. And then this is our all new Ruckus long travel pant.
Oh, look at that.
So this is brand new. This will be launching on the 20th as well.
Mm-hmm.
As part of that collection. More casual feel with the drawstring, but still has the tech and
you
can
go eat afterwards and
exactly,
not look like a coupe.
Exactly, yeah. So comfy fits. Yeah. And then I know you said you're getting cold these days.
It's been cold, dude.
Probably can't see this too well, but this is one of our descent jackets, waterproof.
Nice.
Drop tail hem, got a hood that fits over the helmet.
Over the helmet,
made for riding. But again, it's a casual feel also.
Yeah. Sick. So is mountain biking still just massive in the overall thing for TLD?
Yeah, definitely.
Bigger than moto?
Yep.
Yeah,
that's
so crazy.
It's the largest part of our revenue.
Yeah, you go to Snow Summit and like you see more TLD than anything.
Right.
Even though the mountain's sponsored by another brand, you know?
Yeah, and same, I mean, really, we're kind of like winning silently on the BMX side, and we have for a long time as well.
Yeah.
We see some good sales from Sprint Gear on that side and D4s as well, so.
Nice.
Yeah, you turn on even a World Cup race at that pro level and the start gate is just stacked with D4 helmets, which is pretty cool. Says a lot about a product.
Yeah.
So.
Awesome, man. Well, thank you very much.
Yep.
I'm about 50% of my way through my day of errands, so I have to haul ass and be to my office within 20 minutes. So.
Right on. Well,
thanks, dude.
Yeah,
it's
no
good
worries.
To see you.
You too.
Okay, now we're at Race Tech. From one suspension shop to another. So Race Tech does engine work too. All right, we've been talking about for a while. Here it is, the 24 GasGas MC65, complete with race tech suspension and engine mods. Sweet looking Bill's pipe. This is Andrew Flores, who runs the engine department here at Race Tech, right?
Yep, I sure do.
So the engine department is like the newest department in the building, I'm assuming, right? Because it Race is. Tech's been a suspension giant for years.
Yeah, so we got the engine department going probably about 9 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been here for a little over 9 years. We started it when they hired me on.
Yeah.
So really great opportunity. And we've really grown it into a pretty successful department. We're excited for, you know, the growth that we've had. We don't do full engine builds here, mm-hmm. but we strictly do engine machining services. So okay. we work on the cylinder heads, cylinders, cranks, ECUs on the four-stroke stuff.
Yeah.
We do CNC head porting, standard three-angle valve jobs, performance five-angle valve jobs, mm-hmm. cylinder hones. Really just, we want to open these surfaces up for everybody.
Yeah.
Not just, you know, dealers or teams or anything. It's open mm-hmm. for anyone and everyone.
Yeah, I was dropping the suspension off a while ago, and I saw a couple cylinders in there, and they had Chad Smart's name on them. You know, he owns Baghouse up the street.
Yeah.
And he's rebuilding some mini bike he never had as a kid. And I saw that, I think it was RM85 cylinders in here, so he had some work getting done here.
Yeah, that was a pretty fun project. He's super excited for that. So yeah, he was like, go all out on this thing. I mean, we had to machine his pistons for him to make them work. And
yeah.
we did cylinder head mods and the cylinder mods on that thing. So
nice.
He's excited.
Hey, so it looks like you do all kinds of bikes, street bikes, supermoto, Harleys. But like motocross wise, are you doing more four stroke or two stroke jobs?
We do a lot more four stroke jobs, mm-hmm. But as far as the two strokes, I mean, it's really close second place.
Yeah.
You know, it's,
yeah.
We have our hands full in a lot of the two stroke stuff. So, that's a big part of our business as well.
Okay. So you have your own dynamometer here?
We do. Yeah. We have a chassis dyno. It's out back.
Uh-huh.
And then, that was really fun. Where we started with this KTM 65,
yeah.
or excuse me, GasGas 65.
Yeah. Okay. So getting to this bike then, you guys threw it on the dyno. What did you feel that it was? It had shortcomings.
I mean, there was a massive dip in like towards the bottom end of the curve. I mean, it was crazy how big this dip was. And with the Bill's pipe, it was able to clean that part up
mm-hmm.
A significant amount. But after we did our cylinder porting and our cylinder head mods, it really just got rid of that big dip. So
nice.
It was nice and smooth, nice linear power. Our goal with any of our builds is to use a broad power band.
Yeah.
So we don't want to just shoot for peak horsepower.
Yeah.
We want to,
yeah,
you know, riding
ride,
that thing
man.
On the rev limiter the whole time. That's not our goal. We want to have a good usable power band through all throttle positions.
Cool.
Yeah.
So I guess what'd you do? You ported the cylinder and decked
yeah.
the head or something? Or?
We did. Yeah. We ported the cylinder. We decked the head, boost compression a little bit,
mm-hmm.
Manipulated the squish band just a hair. Really wanted to get rid of that big dip at the bottom end.
Yeah.
But with that, we were able to get rid of the dip and we were able to make more peak horsepower as well. So
sweet.
Wins all around. We're really excited for the guy to, or the kid riding
yeah.
to
yeah,
test his bike
wait,
out.
So. Should make it easier for him to ride with
it should be.
More torque and broader power down.
Definitely.
Cool. And then the suspension was all done. I know you're the motor guy, but this is the complete package racer. Okay. So I'm kind of numb to the whole mini bike world, right? Because like, I've got two daughters and it's like, I'm glad I had daughters because I didn't want to be a mini bike dad. But like when I had the guys test this, just for fun, I'm like, hey, what would you guys do to this bike? Like if it was yours. And they both said, you know, engine work, but they both said a T-Rex throttle. And I'm all, what the hell is a T-Rex throttle? So I did some research and I'm like, wow. This company is huge in mini racing. They make these billet throttles and triple clamps and all that. So I reached out to them on Instagram and they were glad to contribute some parts to this, but it's a whole different world out there, isn't it? This mini bike racing.
Yeah, it is. You know, it's really cool to see these kids want to be so competitive and really mm-hmm. build the engines up where we can. And I mean, I never even heard of the T-Rex throttle either. So I'm excited to get
yeah,
some feedback
on that. Yeah, it's like a billet throttle and throttle two or a cable is Teflon line, so it's real smooth or something. And then they make a triple clamp that's that's better than stock. And I guess I didn't even realize this, but this is like a 1 1/8 bar, and it gets skinny into a micro bar size. Like, we're replacing it with a standard 7/8 setup though.
Mm-hmm. It'll be really cool to see this whole build kind of come together, and looking forward to seeing the final project.
Yeah. Okay, so I always trip out how the Austrian two strokes, they always go, okay, run this one at 80 to 1, run this one at 60 to 1. Like, when I was racing two strokes, I was, you know, bikes came with a sticker that said 32 to 1, and then I would mix it at 50 to 1. Mm-hmm. But like, they obviously are going real lean and stuff, but having built the engine now, what do you suggest for the mixture, and do we do synthetic or caster?
Right now we're doing 40 to 1.
40 to
1. So that's what we'd want you guys to run as well. Okay.
So protect that engine because it revs high.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, as far as like the premix, it's really, it's up to you with what you guys want to run. Typically everyone has their own preference.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we were running just standard Maxima stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'd have to ask my guy what he mixed in it, but.
Okay.
Yeah.
Awesome. So break in. One slow moto, then ride it like you stole it.
Everything's good to go.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, it's broken.
We broke everything in, and then we dynoed it. Yeah. So we broke it in before we dynoed it, and then we have quite a few runs on the dyno. So this thing's ready to rip.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, hey man, Andrew, thank you for taking care of this bike for us. Can't wait to hear what the kids have to say. And I'm gonna need to get a full size bike I can ride in here.
Yeah, that'd be a blast to do for you.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
No problem.
I went up the ramp and I just felt like this crazy burn and pop in my leg. And I knew in the air before I even landed, like, that was it.
This championship now is far from over.
How can you handle adversity and make the best out of it?
All right, it's Low Morals e-bike gang today at Holder Crooks. We got Andre. He's riding the gas. What is this called? The EE6 or something?
EEC6.
He's gonna test it for us today later. Got Alvin, the Turbo Levo. We have Officer Huffman.
Yes, sir.
And Mr. Yulrich from Yamaha. Dude, I haven't seen a silver one.
Yeah, get a good look at it.
Huh?
Best bike out here.
Are you making an edit today?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I'm not really sure, man.
You don't have your GoPro with you?
I do.
You need to film new places.
I was throwing on the chest mount, and this thing is all getting all bunched up, and I'm like, ah.
Oh, come on.
What the heck?
Your YouTube viewers will miss out.
You gave me the motivation that I needed.
YouTube demands it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's that around your neck?
Oh, well, you know, I'm part of the RM Army. So these are my dog tags. Oh. Are the RM Army.
Do they jingle when you ride?
Ah, you know, I don't know yet.
So we've been chilling at the top of the mountain, and the firefighter and the cop are complaining.
Complaining about policies and city politics.
Yeah. In my mouth.
I hit that thing last time.
Okay, ride is done. Always a personal thrill for me to ride with Supercross champion and Blue Blood.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you for your service.
Thank you, Don. Always a good time riding with you.
It's fun, huh?
Had a little fun. Thank you for inviting me out.
Yeah. Great. I got a long drive back to Idaho.
I do. After I work a long night.
Oh, yeah. Bust some people.
You know, fighting crime.
Yeah. Not all heroes wear capes. Thanks, dude. Still fun.
All right, it's Sunday and we're at Fox. Here early. It looks nice. Looking for Scrub Daddy. He's out there cutting in some bad lines.